Welcome to the crown jewel of the Queen City.
So how do you feel about him? $1.3 billion. Let me see. I have the numbers. I have the numbers right here.
I mean, where would you like me to start?
I mean, you can give me everything, no homo. I can't say that. During Pride Week, can I? Pride Month, I meant.
No, just say no Diddy.
No Diddy. Pause. taxpayer would pay $650 million in public money over 4 years between 25 and 29, and Tepper Sports and Entertainment would cover $688 million with a 20-year non-location agreement, or excuse me, non-relocation agreement. And I think it is a 15-year non-relocation clause, and then the 5 years, either the city or I believe the city has the option to opt out or something like that, as far as, you know, relocation or whatever the case may be, which that just simply wouldn't happen. But how do you feel about it? I thought it was a great video, but I'd love to hear your feedback.
Yeah, I mean, I got a couple different thoughts. Long overdue, I would say. The stadium is bullshit. I mean, if you've been inside the stadium, it's just not, like, compared to some of these other stadiums, it's just not that. So the stadium in itself is bullshit. But my only concern is one, having a team to, you know, make the stadium worth going to. So that's a big thing as well, because I was telling Tavian and a couple other people, like, you have to have something that's going to generate that revenue, something that's going to actually look good to the city. Like, we're just not going to, you know, have our people pay their tax dollars to the stadium and then, like, we not get that money back in some way, shape, or form. And
they do, though. I think that's part of the reason why they're doing it, is because of the concerts and Charlotte FC as well. Because it's not only, you know, it's not only the Carolina Panthers, but it's those other revenues, avenues as well.
The reason I can't really throw Charlotte FC in is because they're a young team. And I think the fans in Charlotte are more Panthers football, or more football fans than they are soccer fans.
But this is kind of what I was alluding to earlier when we had this conversation. Like, I think because it's an emerging market, and you don't make an investment like this, like billions of dollars, without like thinking years into the future. And I think the way they see the soccer market growing and everything, and I think the value of concerts and everything, with the way that Charlotte is growing itself, I think it's just really an investment for the city as much as it is for the Panthers.
Well, it's the soccer market in North Carolina. So, to me, I just feel like that's not really a big marketable source, as some people might think. Now, the concerts, that's a different story. But if we got to bank it on the soccer team, then and then also, like, Dave Tepper's putting up majority of the shit. So, I mean, we know he's money hungry. And so I will also say, like, I wish they would have just did a dome. In my opinion.
No Super Bowls. You can damn near, like, guarantee that. No Super Bowls. The NFL is not going to put a Super Bowl in a area where there's no dome, there's no retractable roof. It's just simply not going to happen.
See, that's the thing. I was telling Tavian, like, I think that there is still an opportunity to have a Super Bowl there, even if you don't have a dome. Like, I think that it is less likely, like, more on your spectrum, but I still think that there is a great chance that you can still have a Super Bowl there, because North Carolina is not one of those states where it's just, like, bullshit weather all the time. So, and then you have, like, the attractions, like, the way the stadium is going to look, all of the new specs and technology and shit like that. I think that'll still, like, you know, draw people to want to go there, to want to have a Super Bowl there. So I think that that's still in, like, can be something that can still happen. But yeah. And then also, like, if I was staying in Charlotte, I was telling Tavian this as well, like, and I also heard from somebody at work that's a big Panthers fan, that the people from Charlotte, they're up in arms about it. Because
those new boards.
Yeah. Some of them don't want to, and I get it. Like, people who aren't huge football fans, or maybe not even, or football fans, but just not Panthers fans or Charlotte, like, the soccer team fans, don't want to spend their tax money on building a team or building a stadium for a team who went 2-15. Or if they just don't see the Panthers going in a good direction in the next couple of years, that's not something that you may necessarily want to invest your tax dollars into. And we have a different perspective because we don't live in Charlotte. So we're on the outside looking in, but I understand where they're coming from. So it's a different, it's a lot of different pros and cons. Like, obviously, I'll be happy just because, like, new atmosphere, it'll make the games feel a lot better. But in the grand scheme of things, for what we do, we have a podcast about the Carolina Panthers. At the end of the day, we can go get a drink at the nice concession stand. We can stand up in the little standing only area. We can chat. We can go to the fucking suite level, like get our food, unlimited food and drinks. At the end of the day, we still have to look down from there and then see a bullshit team on the field. So we got to take all of that into account as well. So that's my feelings.
Care to say anything? If not, I'll take the floor.
Yeah, I mean, I don't even know how to follow that.
I think it's a very, very good point. Like you said, I think it's very, very needed. I would say, you know, the couple of NFL stadiums I've been to a good amount. I think maybe probably six or seven of them. And I would say, with the exception of the Washington, with the exception of the Washington Commanders.
They might be changing the name back, by the way. So
I know. Heard. I saw that report as well.
They should, though.
Yeah, they should, for sure. Bank of America is probably in the lower third, I'd say, of NFL stadiums that I've been to personally. Obviously, I can only speak to the stadiums that I've been to. I know for a fact it's not Dallas, and I know for a fact it's not Atlanta neither. So, I mean, just those two, and we're going to Vegas this year as well. So I just know when we go on road and then we got to come back home week four, I don't even remember who we play, but it's just going to feel, I just know it's going to feel so different. I think it's very, very needed. Like you said, I've seen a lot of people upset about the huge LED boards that they're going to put on the outside of the stadium, because if you've been to Uptown Charlotte before and you are familiar with the location of Bank of America Stadium, you know that there's a lot of apartment complexes and apartment buildings that are housed right there, you know, right beside the stadium.
So. And not to cut you off, but yeah, and so I was talking to somebody and they were like, there's a great chance that the stadium, like if they do a new stadium like that, that it could not even be in that same location.
Well, that actually is the agreement. They agreed to keep it there.
Okay.
That's 800 South Mint Street. Yeah. So
they
said that the stadium still has good bones. Is what they said. Yeah. And that it needs to be relocated. That is what the report that I saw said.
That almost sounds.
Yeah.
Is that the term they use?
That is the term that was used. Absolutely. And then it just made me think about how it's rumored that 800 South Mint Street is built on top of a slave cemetery.
To me, that's immediately where my mind went. I didn't even know that, but yeah, that just sounded crazy to me.
Yeah no, that's exactly because we had that conversation when we were talking about Jerry Richardson that one
time. Yeah. But I mean, other than that, like in all actuality and all honesty, I think it's good for the Carolina Panthers. I think it's great for the city of Charlotte. Like you said, we don't live there, so. You know, maybe our view could be a little jaded. However, I believe that it's great for what we're trying to build and what we're trying to accomplish in Carolina. And if you're rebuilding the team and you're starting from ground zero, you know, we need to get up to speed with the technology, get up to speed with the sound systems, put a little couple perks in there, do a little extra shit. Like you said, from the looks of that video as well, it seems like in that 500 level where they have the standing room only patio thing, it looks like seating capacity will be reduced. That's another thing that I haven't seen a lot of people mention, but the way they had that place in the stadium, it looks like they took a section out to put that in there. So I think capacity will probably go down a little bit as well. But, you know, realistically, that doesn't really affect us that much because, I mean, it's not like they're selling out.
I mean, so it'll definitely sell out for the away fans.
Yeah, for sure. And I think, I mean, this is that had to be taken into account as well, because that was kind of, you know, one of the points in the video was from, you know, being a point of travel for people that reside in Charlotte and outside of Charlotte as well. So I think it's a good investment. I hope that everything goes through. I hope that it gets passed. And another report that I saw today, actually, that Dylan sent us was that the team will still be playing in the stadium while renovations are going on. That was something that I had a question about as well, because I was trying to figure out, you know, if we're doing these renovations, these aren't just, you know, these aren't small renovations. These are relatively large renovations, over $1 billion in renovations, with a completely different look to certain concourses outside the stadium. So I was a little skeptical on that, trying to figure out where we would be playing. But they did say we would still be playing in Bank of America while they were going on. And like Tavian hinted at earlier, I mean, it seems like the players are going to champion this as well, because according to Adam Thielen, the Carolina Panthers allegedly have the worst facilities in the NFL.
I mean, he came from Minnesota, where they just completely revamped that shit, too. So
I was about to say, they turned that up completely. So he could be a little jaded, but, I mean, it goes back to the conversation we had last week. I mean, I'm not going to sit here and tell you that he's not wrong, because I've been in the locker room before, and the shit is mediocre.
Yeah, I mean, I don't disagree with that, but then also, when you got to look across the map, to where Kansas City plays at, and then you see how bullshit their locker room and stadium looks, and then, you know, we know what they're doing. So it's like, at the end of the day, play fucking football.